My name is Mark Perez, and I'm the artist fabricator of the Life Size Mousetrap. It does weigh 50,000 pounds. It takes us 5 days to assemble and 2 days to break down. Oh, I used to play the game a lot as a kid, and I got really interested in spectacle and making things really large and big, and living in San Francisco really helps because there's a lot of really awesome art projects. So I decided to make mine the biggest and the baddest, and I think I win. 13 years, we finished in about 2005. I've been showing it ever since, and we're currently on a 6-month tour all across the states, and we are heading to New York City after this.
When you were building it, was the idea always in mind for it to be a traveling show like this?
Yes. I knew I wanted to go out and meet people like you and, you know, get around and do these science centers. It's awesome. Get to meet kids, get to do a little educational thing, and have some adult fun too.
Excellent. I noticed the theme is a very kind of carnival atmosphere to it. Can you tell us how that came about? Is that really kind of going
sort of art carny. It's the modern, we're the modern carnies. They're a dying breed, you know, carnival. You know, people usually get a bad rap sometimes, but not us. We're the artist side. So we make it happen. We're here to educate kids. No one's getting ripped off.
Now, I remember I always had a mousetrap game, and I always lost the pieces, and sometimes it didn't work. How does that, you don't lose the pieces.
Well, sometimes we do. We're having issues now with some stuff, but, you know, we work it all out. It's a Rube Goldberg machine, and every installation's different. You know, dealing with a 3D space, literally. And, you know, we got a whole semi-trailer, 53-foot semi-trailer, 50,000 pounds of stuff. You know, it's just, it's a lot to put together.
Now you guys have been around, 6 years you've been traveling?
About 6 years, yeah.
Where were some of the coolest places you've done?
We've been to Austin, Texas. We've been to the Henry Ford Museum in Detroit, which is cool. We like the New York Hall of Science as well. I'd say, yeah, the Henry Ford's about my favorite now. And of course, Pittsburgh. I'm falling in love with Pittsburgh. Mm-hmm. So it's our first week here.
I heard you guys were doing something special since Batman's filming here.
Yes, indeed. One of our members has made this really giant cardboard Batman effigy, let's say. So we're going to drop our 2-ton safe on Batman on our big finale show tonight.
Nice. Any? What's the craziest show you guys done? You have a lot of live audiences in front of different crowds.
We've smashed a lot of cars before. We did, we made a mouse car once, and we had all the mice all dressed up and rolled that in right underneath the safe, and, you know, it was the junkyard show, so it really worked out. Just, you know, Rube Goldberg's awesome. Keep booking us, we're ready to roll.
Also, are you a fan of, I think it's OK Go, did a video?
Oh yeah, they actually, we got some video out online that has OK Go starting the mousetrap. Because we were at a show in San Jose with them, and some of my friends from LA worked in that show as well, that particular installation of Rube Goldberg. So,
I think I saw you have a website. You want to plug that real quick?
Yeah, lifesizemousetrap.org, and we're there. You're ready to see us, and we're on the tour.